and each time I awoke in the chapel, I leapt again. I tried to enlist the help of the other knights, but none would come to my aid. The inscription says to walk in the faith, but even now, I do not know what this means. Below the chapel of Xenathar in Leowin, there is a shrine to the great craftsman, St. Calidus. Those seeking the mace must pray before the shrine. When you bow, you will receive a vision. Or perhaps not. It is unclear. The priest saw that my body never moved, but it felt so real. You will see the mace separated from you by a great chasm. The chasm represents your doubt. Your faith must be your guide across it. This is what I know. As I said, my faith was weak. I did not understand the test, and I fell from the platform each time I tried to cross. I have told you all that I know. All that is left is for you to prove yourself more worthy than I. If you seek the mace, travel to Leowin's chapel, kneel at the shrine in the Undercroft, and let your faith in the Nine be the salvation of us all. Our greed for the relics overshadowed our faith in the Nine. I can only hope that you are stronger than we were. Legends say that when Pelinol Whitestrake was slain by the Aeliads, a messenger carried the mace to the human settlement of Leowin as a message. Centuries later, the master craftsman St. Calidus built the chapel of Xenathar in Leowin as a tribute to the legend. When St. Calidus was laid to rest, those who prayed to Xenathar at his tomb began to receive visions of the mace of the Crusader. Of the original divines, Xenathar is thought to be the most in touch with the mortal realm. Some legends say that Xenathar has close ties to Kinnereth, an idea that is supported by the manner in which the two gods' realms interact. Craftsmen devoted to Xenathar are able to create and profit from the materials provided by Kinnereth's natural world. The two work in harmony, the natural world providing for the craftsmen. One cannot revere Xenathar without acknowledging the power of Kinnereth.
Okay.
Walk with the Nine, Sir Knight.
I know where you may find the gauntlets of the Crusader, for I was the one who lost them.
You
Though
bastard.
Many know where they are still lost. I believe there is something you must do in order to retrieve them. Would you listen to my tale and learn of the gauntlet's fate?
Sure.
When the Order fractured, I followed Sir Beric into war, taking the gauntlets with me. When it was over, I returned to Cyrodiil. I attempted to return to the service of the Nine, but the war had changed me. I no longer had sympathy for the weak or pity for the suffering. In the brief time I was there, I did more to hurt the chapel than help it. It was there that I was cursed. A beggar who came to the chapel each day for help tried my patience one too many times. I lost my temper and struck him. My blow landed harder than I had intended, and he fell to the floor dead, killed in the very chapel of the God of Mercy. I left the chapel at once, of course, but the damage was done. I was weak, constantly weary, and lacked the energy to do almost anything. Ah, yes. As proof of the deed, when I struck the poor man, the gauntlet slipped right off my hands and fell to the floor. Heavy as stone, they would not move. None could lift them. I suspect they lie there still, in Coral's chapel. You must prove to Stendar you are worthy to lift the gauntlets once more. Seek out the priests in Coral. Perhaps they can help you.
Huh. So he beat the shit out of some hobo.
When Sir Junkin died while questing after the boots, I mourned his loss. It was placed on me for defying the teachings. So he... Go with virtue.
Okay. Coral one sounds like it's gonna be the easiest. So I'll try that one.
Hi.
Oh, there they are.
What's going on with you?
I heard there were some goblins around here recently. A pleasure to speak with you. The gauntlets, eh? They're a Relder's responsibility. Speak to him about them. He seems to be different than you. So Argonians get this hist stuff from licking hist trees, and the Blackwood Company got bad hist that made them crazy.
Yep.
Good day.
Good morning. What brings you here, my son? Ah, yes. The gauntlets have been here for ages. I know only the basic story behind them. They're more of a novelty these days. My only real involvement with them these days is keeping the youngsters from hurting themselves trying to pick the gauntlets up. What is your interest in them, if I may ask? Oh, I'm afraid that's quite impossible. They don't move, not even a bit, as if they're the heaviest things in the world. Don't you know the story behind them? I'm not familiar with all the details, but I know roughly what happened.
Yeah, some guy punched a hobo. Killed him. Yeah, whatever.
Yes. Well, I don't know the whole thing. A great many years ago, a knight of the old order did something terrible, and the gauntlets just fell off. They dropped to the floor right where he stood, and no one could lift them. It was a sign of the curse placed upon this knight by Stendar, I think. That curse still lingers on today, in fact. Poor Kellen. Oh, why, he's a descendant of that very knight from so long ago. The curse has affected his family all these years. He suffers from it now. He came here from Hammerfell seeking a cure, but, well, there's really nothing that can be done for him, I think. He may know more of the story than I. Perhaps you should speak with him if he's feeling well enough. It's a horrible thing, truly. One cannot help but pity those such as Kellen, who have such a burden placed on them through no fault of their own. But if it is the will of the Nine, then there is little that can be done. The gauntlets have been here far longer than any of us. I don't expect that to ever change. They'll almost certainly be here long after we're all gone. Certainly after Kellen's family has died out. He's down in the chapel hall, resting. You may speak to him if you like. Be seeing you.
What is it? Is there a cure? Has Arelder found a cure? I know there's something he's not telling me. Ah, so you've heard it, have you? Terrible curse. Been in the family almost longer than anyone can remember. When I was younger, I could live with it. Wasn't so bad. But until it gotten worse over time, I'd come here, to the place it all happened, in the hopes that something could be done. I fear I haven't much time left otherwise. Arelder has let me stay, mostly out of pity, I think. But there's something else. I swear he knows more than he tells. I've seen plenty of pity in people's eyes over the years. I grew up recognizing it. But with Arelder, there's something else there. And when he speaks to me, there are times I'd swear he sounds apologetic. Guilty, even. Why would that be? What reason does he have to hold back information? I know I'm a doomed man one way or the other. Speak to him if you can. Convince him to tell me what he knows as a dying man's last wish. You've seen them, I assume. The only evidence of what happened so many years ago. Do you know that I thought perhaps I could lift them? That somehow this curse would be lifted if I could pick them up? I tried for hours, until my whole body ached and I could barely move. I lay there on the floor next to them, weeping. I'm not ashamed to admit that. I've been at the end of my rope for far too long to be ashamed of anything. I don't know why they're still here. The church is still in turmoil from the attack on the Chapel of Dibella. I don't think anyone has had time to really study this prophet's teachings. My best advice would be to go, listen carefully, and decide for yourself. I'm sure you've heard that Glistal and Melintus Ancris are living together. Simply shameful. Be seeing you.
Well met.
I heard the most disturbing rumor. Someone told me Francois Moutier has been murdered by the Dark Brotherhood. It's not true, is it?
Welcome, Knight Commander. I cannot face him. I know what might be done for him, but I haven't the will to do it. I wish I could help him. Truly I do. But I cannot muster the strength to damn myself on his behalf. The curse, I know what would lift it, but I cannot do it. The only way to free Kellen of his curse is to take it on myself. I am not strong enough to do this, and so I am a failure. I fail Kellen every time I speak to him, and I fail Stendar every time I pray to him and do not ask for the power to lift the curse. Do you know one who would do such a thing? One who would pray at this chapel's altar, pray to Stendar for the power to lift this curse? I've told you, goodbye.
Hi there. Come back to see the doomed man, have you? Goodbye. Did you? I feel good. I feel good. I don't feel like death. I feel like running. Look at me. I can't believe it. I feel normal. Thank you so much. You have no idea what this means to me. I finally have a chance to get out and see the world. I'm not wasting another second of my life, and I'm forever indebted to you, friend. Farewell.
I turned the mic off while I was eating some cereal for a minute there.
It's you.
Welcome, Knight Commander. You lifted the curse? But that means that now you've cursed yourself. Why would you do such a thing? Take care.
So what effect does the curse have? Damage, fatigue? Well, that's like nothing. Shit, I'll keep it. I just kicked the shit out of that flower.
I can't believe you were willing to do that for... What business do I have acting as a priest if I'm not willing to do all I can in helping those who need it? Perhaps I need to rethink my calling.
Big time. Fucking penis.